Congress has gotten a whiff of the carnival triumph.
You just had this horrible smell in your throat that you couldn't get rid of.
The chairman of the Senate Transportation Committee called it, quote, the latest example in a long string of serious and troubling incidents involving cruise ships. And a veteran U.S. House Democrat, meantime, told us he wants formal investigative hearings.
We have to make sure that our cruise ships are safe, that they're navigating through safe waters. And I think an oversight hearing would be very beneficial. And we just thank God that nobody lost their life.
After the Concordia disaster off Italy, the Coast Guard told Congress it was reviewing whether to adjust requirements for safety drills on cruise ships. Passengers like Linda Sanford, who survived a cruise mishap near Mexico, asked Congress to get more involved.
I crawled out of the ocean on my hands and knees, clawing into the shore.
Our review of recent federal legislation found proposals to limit the pollution pouring from cruise ships. One bill cited 210,000 gallons of human sewage generated by ships each week. Other proposals would beef up security on ships. The industry avoids some U.S. regulations by registering in foreign countries. And Carnival alone spends an estimated $1.5 million lobbying D.C.
In part because they're a lightly regulated industry, the cruise lines, the cruise ships, when it comes to U.S. regulations. And they want to keep it that way.
Just got this statement from an industry spokesman with Cruise Line International Association who said, quote, every aspect of the cruise experience is heavily regulated and monitored under both U.S. and international maritime law.